right, so we're talking to a comedian in the house. Comedy in Nigeria is a very, very big business, believe me. It's big business. Everybody wants to be a comedian. They're comedians, and they are comedians indeed. And we have one of such right here with me. Hello. You're welcome, Shola.
Thanks a lot.
Can I call you Shola or Samson?
Shola Samson, that's a full
Shola
name.
Shola Samson.
There.
So your surname is Samson?
No, my surname is Shola.
Your surname is Shola.
Yes, but you know when you're in school, they say surname first. Every exam you write, they say surname before the name. So that's how the teachers talk like that.
It's that's cool. Yeah. Cool. Nice to meet you. You're welcome.
Pleasure.
So we're talking about Comedy in Nigeria. How is the industry?
Well, the industry is booming. Everybody's upping his game. Ease our game because there are females in the industry too. So, And even the females, no one agrees. They say they hot. They say everybody hot now.
Yeah.
Bloody hot.
Mm-hmm. And so the competition is really
high.
Tight.
It's high.
It's really tight.
It's tight.
But don't you think that this kind of industry talent would actually set you apart from other people?
Yeah, like my father in the business would say, or when you say that there's a difference between a comedian and a comic.
Mm-hmm.
There's a difference.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you know, for people who are comic, they tell stories, they tell jokes, they can tell other people's jokes.
Mm-hmm.
But for a comedian, he doesn't have to tell a joke, but he can make a joke from anything that is serious. I don't know if you understand.
Yeah.
Anything he says can just, spontaneous, that's the word. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
That's it.
Okay.
You don't learn work.
So what's your style of comedy? Is it like you just come up with anything on the spot, you survey your audience? What do you do?
Well, for me, I'm a spontaneous person.
Okay.
Because I learned from Owen Gee, and I'm an actor. I have a program on DSTV.
Mm.
Can I mention that there?
No, you've already mentioned. Okay. Carry on. You have a program.
Okay, I have a program on it, and it's called Skits. It's Skits, but not. It's called LAL. That's a program.
LAL.
LAL. Laugh out loud.
Laugh out loud.
Yes.
No, LOL.
The out there is AWT.
Out.
Yes. Oh, yes. So it's laugh out loud, and it's really compilation of skits. We wrote about over 50 skits.
Okay.
You know, it's showing every Saturday 8 p.m. on African Magic Urban.
Oh, that's
and,
nice.
And it's really nice. We're getting more people to watch it and all that.
Okay, so that means you can come up with something right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, like what?
Look at me now. Inspiration. Be inspired.
Okay, joke or what?
Don't insult. Don't insult me because I know the first thing that comes to the mind is, let me just yap this babe. Some people come from there.
You know, these days, talking about women, girls, you know, a girl came to visit me last week, and then she was, you know, a very fine girl like you. She looks like you, sir, very fine, you know. And then we're watching TV, and then she said, I wanted to remove a particular CD and put another one. She was like, no. And my friends were there. No, don't come out it. It was so terrible that my friends started laughing at me. I said, God. Immediately, I just told her, let me escort you. She said, are you driving away? I said, let me escort you, please. I want to come out to you now.
Well, seriously, what is wrong with small background now?
No. That, for a girl who forms very well, and then the next thing, she does background again.
Ah,
you know, it's terrible.
No, it kills you.
If you don't know English, you don't know English. There's no point.
Just speak pidgin. Okay, now, talking about communication and comedy, most people choose to speak Pidgin, most people choose to speak English. Is it really difficult to change your style? Like maybe if you're used to Pidgin or you're used to English and you go to an environment where maybe everybody understands only Yoruba. Is it difficult to communicate that way?
Okay, you know, there's a comedian, not every comedian fits every occasion.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that everybody, I mean, some are used to Pidgin English jokes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then you have to read the audience well.
Right.
You know, for you to take somebody who is very vast in Pidgin English, who became popular by speaking Pidgin English,
Pidgin,
to a Yoruba setting,
mm-hmm.
it has to be spontaneous. It will be very difficult for him because, he will not be able to cope on time with that because the audience are not used to his communication skill.
Mm.
You know, so you need somebody who is very fast, who can speak Pidgin, who can flow in any environment to fit into such a gathering.
Okay.
So that's how it works.
All right. So now your mentor, you talked about Owen Gee as your mentor.
Yes.
So
I'm not going to stop to mention the name. If you verse. No,
don't worry. I'll help you. Owen Gee.
If you verse.
So Owen Gee as your mentor, were you a funny guy before you met ONG or you came to him and you were like, bros, man, I want to do comedy as business. Please teach me how to be funny.
Man, I don't do comedy since, you know, ever before I came to Lagos. Now, I'm not one of those who say I wasn't worried. I'm not a worry boy. I've never slept in worry before. I don't pass them. I never slept there before.
Okay. You
know, I was in Ogun State.
Whoa.
There's a place called Otta.
Otta Farm.
Yes. Not farm, not the farm, because I'm mentioning farm now. I was in Otta. And, you know, then I was a local champion there. Every gig you see my name, Shola, I will crack jokes every year.
Mm.
And the highest they could pay me then was 500 naira.
Oh, my God.
I'm telling you, it was terrible. And then there's this girl I was dating then. The girl called me. We did that for 4 years. The girl called me. I said, Shola. I said, sir. I said, ma. I wanted to say sir because she was the one feeding me then.
Mm.
She called me into her bedroom because every day I would go and eat in her house. She would cook for me. So that day she called me and said, is this what you want to do to feed me and my children?
Oh.
He said, there's no future in this business. Go and look for a job. I thought you went to university. You went to LASU. Go and look for a job. She started abusing me. I was shedding tears. I mean, I couldn't cry. You know, there's a way something will happen to you. You don't want to cry.
Mm.
But you want to cry, but you don't want to cry. So the tears was about coming. I was using system to push it back, you know. And then the girl said, see, that she finished me that day. And she told me that she was holding somebody to marry her, who is a banker.
Ah.
And that the person is in the parlor waiting for her, that she will eat my food and go.
Wow.
Imagine, how am I supposed to eat such a food? Even though I was hungry. Immediately the hungry disappeared. I said, me, eat this food, I might die.
Whoa.
You know? So looking at such, these are part of the things that made me say, no, I want to go to Lagos. Because then, you know, if you know Lagos, we have too many comedians in Lagos.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There are so many of them.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I came to Lagos, I was at Teju's show, Teju Babyface's show,
mm-hmm.
comedy last month, 2006.
Okay.
And, you know, after that girl last me, I stopped doing comedy for some years.
Oh.
Because I started teaching, you know. Even as a teacher, I was teaching well because the kids were almost always laughing. The headmaster would come and look at me and say, this guy, you're not supposed to be here. Go and do either comedy or that drama. I said, sir, please let me stay here. Because the time the man paid me 2 months salary stretch.
Wow.
He said, look, my friend, go to Lagos. Go and do comedy or do acting. You're not a teacher.
Wow.
He said, no, you're not teaching well. You're teaching well, but this is not your calling.
Mm.
But I was scared ministry. Because the girl has put fear in me. You understand? That's why you need to find a good wife. Not say, you know, I'm talking to my people outside there. You know, not every girl is a good wife.
We're talking about the Oni Ofife, his new wife. How okay. The gods? How would you like that kind of scenario? God will just select your wife for you.
My sister, I'm not gonna lie for you. If God wants select for me, he select either Dangote Pikin.
Do you have any spec?
Because that one, you know, I have a spec. You know, somebody like you. I like that spec. I'm not saying you understand?
Yeah, but somebody like me.
Somebody like you.
Yeah.
But she has to be very, you know, very, very, you know.
Very rich.
So that when comedy knows, we're going to say,
but you're making it well now. You're making it very well.
Yeah, we're making it well, but yeah, my sister, at the time,
sometimes, you know,
say,
it's dry.
At the time. Nobody say dry. At the time. At the time. You know, say, they say, Mike, the friend, one billionaire, Pekin. You know, that one a future investment. That I can't define. Nobody else
will get me. You are looking at it from a monetary aspect. You're
my sister,
like an Igbo man now.
I'm an Igbo man by association. You understand? Because when you look at the future, the way dollar they rise now, making you say dollar come become 1,000.
Eh, wait.
Maybe when you get 1,000 and $1, how you want to have one now?
So you're investing in your future very soon.
And they look future, my sister. They find person way. Even if God want to choose for me, God should just come and go minister to them first. Dangote, I'm not saying that call your name. Adenuga, I'm not saying that call your name. Shola Samson is your
dollar.
Future son-in-law. Sponsor the wedding. Give him a mansion in Abuja, in Los Angeles, in Canada, everywhere. Give him a mansion everywhere.
I think I'm going to be like that principal in your life today. This is not your calling. You should be an armed robber.
You're a primer for me.
I'm serious. I have a...
No, bad primer with that too.
No, I'm just kidding.
I jump and pass.
Amen. I jump and pass for you too. But now, on a serious note, this cannot be serious because it's comedy anyway. Talking about your business, what you do, what the show that you're involved in now, the show that you do, you sponsor, you talked about short skits.
Yes.
You bring skits together and all that. Is it originated by you? Maybe you think of the idea and you bring people together and they act it out, or you do the skits yourself and you get the ideas from people. Other people write jokes for you and you act it out. How is the show?
The point is, I'm a co-owner of the show.
Okay.
I have a partner who brought money, who's the EP.
Okay.
So he contacted me and then told me to find a few other comedians who are young who can also act.
Okay.
And then we came together, wrote jokes. I wrote more of the jokes.
Oh, okay.
And then we merged them together and shot them. But they're fresh jokes. They're not heard anywhere.
Okay.
And some of those jokes, I can't say them on stage because it's exclusively for
that skits platform. And all that. So is it that you, how do you make your money back? Do you get jobs from the show, or maybe there's a form of honorarium you get from showing the show on television?
Yes, we sold them to DSTV.
Oh, and, you sold them?
Yeah, we sold them. Yeah.
Okay, so you shoot them on your own, then you take the...
Yeah, take it there. And then we're also selling to other platforms too, like internet and the rest.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. That girl that you talked about, is she married now?
She's married.
She's married. When last did you talk to her?
I don't want to talk
about it. You want to talk about it? Okay. So looking forward, what are your plans for the future as a comedian? I know everybody will talk about, oh, I want to be the biggest brand in Nigeria. What do you have in store?
Okay. I have two film scripts.
Okay.
Not like the AY own. AY is good. I like him. I respect him.
Mm-hmm.
But mine is from start to finish, funny. Mm. Very funny. I'm telling you the truth. Very, very funny because it took me... how many years to write those film scripts?
Okay.
There are two of them.
Okay.
And to shoot them would require some good money.
Mm.
Because I want to be able to pay everybody that will act on it. I don't want to do manage, no.
Mm-hmm.
I want to shoot it with very good cameras, good equipment and all that.
All right.
You know, so I want to be able to shoot my own films. I want to do films because I read theater arts in last year and one of my passions is to do films.
Nice,
you know,
nice.
So I want to do films. I want to do good films.
Okay.
And also bring in the likes of Kevin Hart to also, you know, act on it.
Mm.
You know, so that's what I want. I want to be that guy. If you watch some of these Hollywood films, I want to be able to feature on it and then bring the Nigerian culture into it. You know, speak it in English in a Hollywood film.
That's
what I want to do. I'm
nice.
Looking at that and I know it will come to pass.
Amen. Amen. So Nigerians are
Amen. Offering time.
What? Seriously? Nigerians are very, very, we're hustlers. Can I use the word hustlers? We are very strong people. We know how to survive. Now, you may say something is funny in one person's perspective and it may not be funny to the other person. Have you ever had a situation on stage where you actually cracked the joke and people were just, has it happened to you?
Yeah, it has. It has. Every comedian has one or two times where...
Odd times.
Yeah, it happens.
How did you... find your way out of it.
But it's not a good experience. I don't lie to you. It's not. You know, I remember when I went to Ring Road for an Easter, you know, comedy blast in Benin. And you know, Benin people are very stubborn people. And they tell you, very, those people, the end person carry out. You know, when we went to that show, my brother, the best comedian in Uniben, I can't remember the guy's name.
Mm.
It was me, Gandoki, Clean the Drunk, there's a guy called Obolo Singer. If you go to Benin, there's a guy. Obolo that Singer. Guy is too much.
Mm.
He doesn't want to come to Lagos. He's just there and he's chopping money.
Mm.
You know, it was a big show. So when that show, and then they called that guy. The guy was the best comedian in Uniben. When the guy came on stage, every joke the guy was saying, I was rolling on the floor. Nobody laughed.
Whoa!
I am telling you. It got the time that the audience carried the ragolis as if they planned it. Maybe somebody shared, maybe somebody imported Ragolis water for them. They started stoning this guy. This guy was running for his life. I was almost crying for this guy. And then the MC came, Elvis, and said, Shola, you are next. I said, hey, I don't die today. Hey, if this guy made a pieces like this, then I used to go to pursue this guy. When I came to the stage, I said, God, now you say, make I do comedy. I want to go for bank before. You say, make I do comedy. If you let me shame, man, I used to be, you know, concern me. I came to this, I said, people, I want beg you now, I beg. Where I come from, foul. The minute they started laughing.
Oh.
I said, look, make I tell you now, they call me the burnt offering of comedy. They started laughing. And that was how I started using that slang everywhere I go. I
just burnt offering of
I'm
comedy.
I'm telling you, man, it was entering.
It worked.
I know you can see it work. But I define wife.
Advertise.
But I don't want black girls.
Yeah, you've already mentioned it earlier now.
I don't
she
want
must
black girls.
Rich.
My father has warned me not to marry a black woman.
What if she has recessive gene of fairness in her body?
I must see it.
How? How would
because,
you see it?
Because imagine me will be like this. Come go marry girl with black. What do we go born? Nepa. And they tell you, so I don't want them. Let me say, we'll come back and we'll go to the touchlight to find the begin. Where they begin, they cry for you. Where they cry here now. Look for a touchlight. Hello, Jim Bob. No. I want to marry a light-skinned girl.
Okay.
For colors correction.
Okay.
You know, that's what they call colors correction.
Yes, color
in,
correction.
In GNS 102.
Uh-huh. 102 color correction.
I want to color this. I want to correct this color.
You can bleach now.
No, I don't want to bleach.
So you want a fair, okay, that's one. Number girl. One, you want a fair girl. Mm. Uh-huh. She must be rich.
Yeah, she must be rich.
Number
she
two.
Must get money.
If she doesn't have
all money, the girls will not get money, no apply, please.
What
no apply.
A potential.
Like which kind of potential? It depends. It depends on the hardworking.
Yeah.
You know, women these days, when you say hardworking mean different things.
Okay.
You understand?
Okay.
If I hardworking to you, might not be hardworking to me. So
okay,
it might
so
be
hardworking to you.
Well, to me, hardworking be say, if what I do, well, you must support me. I want to do a show, bring money. Bring money. Let's do the show.
Okay.
Now, this is me that.
So, three special requests. Uh-huh. Fair.
And I don't want a short girl because I don't say I'm not too tall, so I don't want to have bone. I don't want people like Akian Popo. No.
But I would disagree with you.
And I don't want ugly girl. Because I don't want to have people like Segwa Rinze. Or people like Ofuneka. Or people like Omo Baba. No. I want a fine girl. We're fine. We settle down fine.
Settle down fine.
And I don't want girls who have big eyes because those ones can see into the future. You understand? If you can't deceive them. Because girls who have big eyes, they can see. If you lie to them, they will see that you're lying. You say, baby, I see you are lying to me. You are lying. I'm seeing it now. Baby, you're going to cheat on me tomorrow. I've seen it. I've seen it. I don't want that. Girls who have moderate eyes.
Moderate eyes. Like
and I don't want a girl with big nose. You understand? Because I keep telling people, see, I was part of a team to inspire kids, where telling them what they want to be when they grow up.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know that some people, when you see them in the morning, you don't know whether they are crying or they are laughing. Their face, now show their face, be person face be like this. You greet them in the morning, good morning. Morning. Good afternoon. Afternoon. You don't know if he's crying or he's laughing. And I ask this young girl said, what do you want to be when you grow up? The girl stood up and said, uncle, I want to be Miss World.
Yeah.
Like Agbani the Rigot. I said, my friend, sit down with his face. Then I called the next boy. That one get bad leg. Then he was on up. He said, uncle, I want to be a footballer. I want to be scoring goals like Kanu. I said, my friend, sit down. Then I called the next boy. That one need to see. And you know, in the north, Bible says, fear not. They say that is why if they send anybody to MIC, they need to go. Because the Bible says, fear not. It is only in the north that you are praying and you are watching. Because you don't know where the next bomb is coming from. Pastor will come to church and say, let's pray. What's that in there? Take it away from. I went to perform in a church in Kano 2 weeks ago. A pastor came to church. He said, today, we are going to pray against. People of God, pray against. He said, why is this mic not working? Whenever I want to shout, the mic will not work. He said, why? He said, no, tell me why. Tell me why. Then change mic. Then change up to 15 mic, the same thing. He said, people of God, I want you to shout, pray against. Now I say, pastor, pray. You said, pray that prayer. He said, don't pray the prayer. They can't kill you. They can't bomb your body. I said, eh, prayer. Now when they pray, they go. The next one will go, yeah, bah! Pastor, don't move. Now pastor call me. Brother Shola Samson, I said, sir, are you still alive? I say, pastor, hold on, I'm alive. He said, so they have killed everybody. I say, pastor, hold on. It was a balloon busted. He said,
oh my God.
It was a balloon busted. He says, I'm talking to you now, I'm in Red Sea. I'm crossing to Libya. I'm telling you.
Hey, yo.
Atia.
Hey, it's here.
When I give me balance, huh?
Yeah, you try.
When I give me balance,
huh? No, so money you didn't think of. You should have been an evil guy. So, when is your next show coming up?
For now, I want to do more of skits.
Okay, skits. So no stage, skits. No.
No show for now. Stage, yeah.
Okay, so how do people follow you if they want to and hear more jokes and watch more skits on Instagram, Facebook, or your social media?
At the SS of comedy.
SS.
Yes.
Of
the,
comedy.
Yes.
The SS
of comedy.
Okay.
Or at Shola Samson.
Shola Samson.
Yes.
Where is he at SS of comedy and where is it at Shola Samson?
Twitter, anyone.
Okay, anyone.
Anyone. Just choose anyone you like.
Okay. Mm. Thank you so very much, Shola Samson. I've actually cracked two of my ribs. You have to take me to the hospital.
I'll back you to the hospital.
Okay, so this is the end of the first sit down. I really, really enjoyed myself. And I'm going to continue enjoying myself after this, okay? When we get back, don't